Okay, well, let's start. Good evening, guys. College of Bay, today. This is our final product for the final project called Whale Micro. You guys are living in Ulsan with me now, and in Ulsan, whales are ubiquitous. They literally feed them everywhere. But have you wondered why? What's with whales and Ulsan? I mean, what is the relationship? This goes back to thousands of years ago, to our very old ancestors who hunted bravely for whales. And since then, whales used to appear prevalently on Ulsan's shores, and this was how it all began. Ulsan and whale had some good relationships, as well as some bad ones. For many years, Ulsan and whale were inseparable. So, our final project is to design and create a creative product that relates to whale or Ulsan. So our team has investigated some existing whale products, such as, a little bit disappointing, so I'm not really sure. How about this one? Still not quite sure either. Getting a little bit bent up. Now we're talking. But is there anything more creative? More aesthetically pleasing? Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you. The Whale Micro. This spherical, sleek, curvilinear-shaped whale micro resembles a dolphin jumping out of the ocean. The dynamic movement of lines around the globe grasps the vibrancy of dolphins jumping out of the ocean. The globe is finished with a fine metallic painting that harmonizes with the navy blue of the globe you can see right there. The Whale Micro is magnetic levitating silver and blue globe. It is a 16.0 control processor per second installed computer control with intelligent software that ensures a stable, freely floating globe. The night light function in the LED, right here, turns on when the globe floats. The globe diameter is 10 centimeters, and it's in the scale of approximately 1 to 128 millimeters. The product also has a speaker function that connects to your iPhone, iPod, or MP3 for music. So, this was the design process that we carried on. We started from design ideation, and we ended up on the finishing process. This simple sketch we started started the sanding. More sanding, and more sanding, even the hole. And then we applied the primer layer to our three models with the help of Professor Self as well. And then we came more sanding. More, and more, and more, and more, and more. And then we finally got to spray our very expensive metallic Tamiya spray paint. This is the completed part. And then we assembled our product with the help of the almighty individual. And this is the finished product. And we'll give you a little demonstration of how it actually works. It's supposed to make the gloves float using the magnetic levitation energy. we're experiencing some mechanical difficulties. objects, so we have to put putties all over it and sand it again. Also, this actually floats really well if you do it again. Anyway, so the calculating weight of this filter was very comprehensive process, because otherwise if this was too light, it would just stick to the magnet. But if this was too heavy, then it wouldn't just do anything. So we did many trials and came up with the one that actually floats. And when we were assembling it, we were too excited, so our hands got a little hot and left these nice awful finger marks all over our beautiful metallic surface. And further study, we have a fire. So this is our thinking outside the square. We didn't just remain in the solid works and printing it out and ta-da, this is our model part. We actually applied in a virtual world. I don't know if everyone knows this game called Sims, but it's where you experience a virtual life. You choose a family or a person, you choose a house, and you choose a life they would live in. And we used different 3D models called the UV mapper, which is UV mapper to make a texture map to add color. And then we opened this in this is the milkshake, which is similar to 3D Max, and this is the UV mapper that we made to make the texture map. And then we opened that file in the TOS, our workshop, to make the item for Sim. And this is how it looks on a virtual world. You might recognize it, Lily. And when the music comes out, happy. More color study is that because we use the traditional method of sanding and spray painting all by our hand, maybe if we use some advanced refining method, then the overall quality of our product would be much better. And if we did more studies on how magnets do and all the levitating here works, we could create more creative. And some of the lessons learned is the importance of practicality of design. At the beginning of the design process, we had these wonderful ideas, but they were really hard for us to materialize or manifest in the physical terms because of our lack of knowledge as well as lack of skills. And we faced many problems during our design process, and this what our difficulties were. All part of the hardships that we're facing now, but we learn to be positive and never give up. And also learn to think outside of square. Thank you.
Can we try that function? It really was hard.
So while he's working on that, we'll show you our promotional video.
Have you ever been to Ulsan? Famous for being an industrial city. The world's only Hangul petroglyph. The famous whale festival. Huge statues that resemble the whales in Hangul petroglyph. Modern whale sculpture at Ulsan KTX station. A traffic sign for at the bus stop. Even on top of manhole lids to whale-shaped frame. You can easily experience and feel the closeness of whales in Ulsan. For anyone who wants to feel as if they are always in Ulsan, the whale night glow is the perfect glow.
Thank you. 아침 6시에 일어나 좋아하는 운동을 할 때도 운동이 끝나고 목욕을 할 때도 애써 준비한 퀴즈를 내주려고 했다가 학생들이 CAD 수업 때문에 기지개를 드랍해버려 처리 이메일을 보낼 때 좋아하는 커피를 마실 때도 미안 크리시와 같이 이야기를 나눌 때도
마음만 해서 좀 뭐 제품볼 이렇게 제품 강조해주시고 뭐 이걸로 이제 불러 돌리거나 이렇게 하시면 돼요. 네, 주말은.